Well, good evening, folks. I thought as we get used to this strange new normal, we just think a little bit about church. Because what is church? We hear things like, oh, there's no church at the moment, or church has been postponed, church has been cancelled. But is that church? Or is there something that we're missing if we think like that? Perhaps it'd be good just to spend some time thinking about church this evening. So, what does the Bible say about church? Well, let's read in 1 Corinthians first and chapter 1 and the second verse. Unto the church of God which is at Corinth, to them that are sanctified in Christ Jesus, called to be saints, with all that in every place call upon the name of Jesus Christ our Lord, both theirs and ours. Paul is obviously not there addressing a building, he's talking to a group of people. He's talking to the church. And the word there they use, the Greek word is ecclesia, the word for church, and it means those who are called out. So the church is the called out ones, those who have been called out of the world and called into a relationship with God. Clearly, that's the church. And if we look over in in 1 Peter, we read these words in chapter 2 of 1 Peter. But you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. Once you were not a people, but now you are the people of God. Once you had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy. And then in Ephesians it says, Ephesians 1 and 22, 23 says, and God placed all things under his feet and appointed him to be head over everything for the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills everything in every way. Amen. So the church is not a building. The church is you and me, those of us who have been called out. So has church stopped? Definitely not. Is church finished? It's not. It's just functioning in a different way. So it's good for us to just consider these things and think about it and pray that God would really bind us together in his love. Even though we're apart, we might know a unity. We might know a joy of being bound together as part of that one body that makes up his church. Those ones who have been called out to serve him, called out to love him, called out to worship him. Bind us together in love.
Cords that cannot be broken. together, Lord, bind us together with cords that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together, Lord, bind us together.
So we come now to a time of prayer. Let's pray. We pray for a renewed sense of our being one in Christ and for a deeper sense of our belonging together and to each other, for a new joy in being the people of God and a fresh delight in each other's fellowship. May our life together bring glory to God. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for a new desire to help, care for and support each other, and a new readiness to give encouragement and thanks for all that we receive through our fellowship in Christ, for a new joy in accepting and affirming even those with whom we disagree. May our fellowship in Christ bring hope to our neighbour. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for a new acceptance of each other's worship and a new openness to share in each other's praise, for a new willingness to listen to each other's witness to the truth, and for a new ability to break out of our prejudiced positions and to break down all the walls that divide. May the love of Christ bind us together. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for a new sharing of each other's pain and sorrows, a new listening to others' doubts and fears, a new desire to accept and affirm every member, and a new welcome for all who feel they are strangers. We ask to be set free from any sense of self-righteousness and from anything that would hinder the declaration of the good news. May the power of the Holy Spirit make us new. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for a church that can live with diversity and with the tensions caused by those we think are different. For a church that can welcome all those with different hopes and fears, different visions and dreams, different words and ways, different songs and prayers. We ask for God's grace to blend them into one body in Christ. May our oneness in Christ bring glory to God. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for a church that declares the good news, for the poor in body, mind, or spirit, for a church that gives high priority to prayer and outreach, to mission and service, to the gifts and fruit of the Spirit, for a church that declares Christ as Saviour and Lord, and places him and his kingdom at the heart of all that it says and does. May the Spirit set us free for Christ. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Amen. And we'll join together now with the prayer our Lord taught us to pray. So we say together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. And we're going to bring our time this evening to a close with the words from the prayer book for evening prayer. O God, from whom all holy desires, all good judgments, and all just works proceed, give to your servants that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey your commandments, and that we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen. Amen, and God bless. Until the next time. Good night.